But Horse Guards Parade in fine fettle tonight. A full house, all expecting, waiting for a showdown between these two nations. Temperature dropping quite rapidly, 15 degrees Celsius. Well, the wind has dropped a little bit with it. Not too much though, it's been a real problem today. It's been gusting around the arena, changing the trajectory of some of the serves. But Semenov and Prokopyev, combined age of 48. Where Gibb and Rosenthal, on the other hand, 68. Gibb and Rosenthal are the 2012 World Tour winners, though. And they come in here as the informed team. They may not have come first in the Olympic rankings, but they finished a couple of months ago. And a couple of events after that, and Gibb and Rosenthal have been on scintillating form. Semenov, you're looking at their 6'11". He's huge. Prokopyev defends at the back. Semenov, predictably with his height, bosses the net. The players finish a 3-minute warm-up. It's the journey, two losses and a win. So the Russians take third in Pool C, which is why they've got such a hard round now. The Americans topped Pool D, but only just. Poles Fijalek and Prudel were the first people to make it through to the quarterfinals, the only people who beat them. Still didn't drop many sets though. Just introducing the referees. Wang Leijun from China is up on the net. Daryl Friesen from Canada on the sand. So the Russians teamed up in 2012. They played a couple of times together before this, but they saw their chance at the Continental Cup to qualify. Sergei Prokopyev, 25 years old, 6'4", but he is dwarfed by Konstantin Semenov, 6'11", 23 years old. He's had a couple of decent results in the lead up to this, a couple of them on the World Tour, but they have exceeded all expectations to make the round of 16 here. The Americans though, Jake Gibb, 6'7". Not many people who stand 6'7" will have to give an opponent 4 inches, but that's what Gibb's up against. Sean Rosenthal, 6'4", 32 years old. Teamed up in 2006. They've won this year's World Tour. And are, I think, the team to beat here. They've been all of the best this year. They're not going to have any hang-ups about the Brazilians or the Germans. They've been working with the new coach, Mike Dodd. Won a silver first time beach volleyball, debuted at the Olympics in Atlanta in 96. And that has really turned their fortunes around. They've had a couple of middling years, but since they joined up with Dodd at the start of 2012, they've started to hit form. Russians are going to serve from the left-hand side. Just loops that one over. Gibb taps that one to the back of the court. Semenov makes it. Gibb's going to have to give him a nice easy pass. He chooses not to. And that is a schoolboy error in my book. That far away from the net, with no momentum, he wasn't going to be able to attack that ball. He had to take a sensible, potentially a vulnerable option, but instead he wasted the point anyway. Semenov sets. Prokopyev. Wow, if that ball was a potato, it would have turned the American side of the court into a plate of bangers and mash. Ibn Rosenthal being the sausages. Semenov to serve. Rosenthal sets. Prokopiev down well. Rosenthal got the dig and then unleashes the spike. It comes off the net. What a point. Russian showing fantastic poise and patience there. They waited for their time. The Americans did exactly the same thing. Shows that both teams just wanted to warm up a little bit. This is going to be an interesting game. Two-one to the Russians. Precocious talent. Give there. Wasn't hanging around. Sent that one downtown. You get the feeling with Semenov and Prokopiev, they haven't actually played on the tour that much. There's the sneaking suspicion that they found this remarkably easy, and they're wondering what all the fuss is about. Bit too close to the net. Gibb gets a hold of it though. Russians rebuild. Go over in two. Gibb reads it like a cheap paperback and sends it right back where it came from. Lovely work by the American. Gibb to serve. Americans lead 3-2. Semenov sets. And another block from Gibb. Russians maybe realizing what there is to fear about this team. I don't think that they've had an easy route through to the round of 16, but the Americans represent the first real medal hopes that they've faced, I suppose. Gopiev. Making that one count though. Gibb and Rosenthal undoubtedly stepped it up a gear though. I think they're on about DEFCON 3 now, having walked out here on 1 or 2. Defence condition 3. There are 5 on the scale. And I think that's reserved for Emmanuel and Alisson. Semenov sets back. Prokopiev. Big spike, but the Americans deal with it. Recycle the ball. And it's a big spike for Gibb that comes off Semenov at the net. The Americans lead 5-3. So Gibb just moving over there. I think the Russians felt he might be screening. It was it. Put Rosenthal off enough. There's an unforced error. Sticking the ball in the net. So Semenov, the tower of power, sends that one over. Rosenthal did well in two. On a huge dig there from Prokopiev. Gibb was looking for it. Goes back into again. The Americans playing very fast here. I wonder if they're trying to fluster the Russians at all. Oh, and it's just inside.
No.
Semenov.
Two action. No. Please.
Semenov sure that he saw the hands touch the bottom of the net. I think he's saying he saw. Is it Gibb's hands touch the bottom of the net? Be on the next part of this point here. There, no, they were nowhere near it, were they? Semenov not afraid to approach the ref. Two or three matches now, we've seen him getting quite het up about decisions that haven't gone the Russians' way. Great block from Gibb at the net. Russians got it right into the corner there to get the best angle of attack. Gibb read it. cracks. Prokopiev as he comes in. He closes down from the line right across there. And very little open to Prokopiev then. So the Americans lead 7-4. Russians had 12 attempts in attacking, just 3 successes. In fact, it's a terrible ratio, 25%. But the Americans aren't much better. They're not quite at 30. Maybe about 27. So a lot of good work being done at the net and a lot of long rallies. People in Swan here from France in the crowd. There are a good mixture of flags in the audience. Certainly not as many Russian flags as there are American now. I think the Russian fans might be a little more subdued. Semenov set. Prokopiev finds space this time, but Rosenthal was there and he positions that ball beautifully behind Prokopiev, and the Americans are dismantling the Russian defense now, piece by piece. It'll be interesting to see how long the Russian morale holds out in the face of this onslaught. They'll be crying into their beers if it keeps up for another 20 minutes. Yeah! Semenov with a big fat dose of confidence right there. Refusing to lie down. Getting a little bit carried away though. It's actually Prokopiev's serve. Prokopiev. Floats that in to Gibb. Rosenthal sets. Gibb. That was, he made that look like low-hanging fruit. I'm sure it was an awful lot harder than he made it look. Just uses the back of his fingers there. Pokes the ball over a 6'11" man in front of an 8-foot net and drops it perfectly into the corner by the line. Americans lead 9-5. Rosenthal serves. Semenov sets. Notice the Americans haven't once, I don't think, served directly to Semenov. They don't want that man at the net. It goes over in two. Rosenthal finds it quite easily. Into the corner, and he looks again for the line, but Prokopiev's there. Prokopiev comes off. Oh my goodness, it came off Gibb. And Rosenthal threw himself at that. Gibb claiming a net touch, the referees disagree, and the Russians get another point. The MC here is shouting rush, the crowd are shouting ah. Certainly, the Horse Guards Parade crowd have backed the underdogs today. And the round of 16 tens to dish up a lot of favourites and underdog battles, mainly because third placed teams from the group stages are facing the top teams. So there's a lot of the medal teams facing some of these late teens, early 20s ranked world teams. I think the Russians only just slip inside the top 50. Certainly they're not playing to that ranking at the moment. Serve just overrunning for the Americans, so Prokopiev lines up. 7-10. Russians have really closed the gap. Gibb sets. Rosenthal. Well read by Prokopiev. Rosenthal again with the dig. He's so busy, but it goes straight into Semenov's block. And the Russians are getting pumped up here. So Semenov starting. struggling to find some traction at the net there. Prokopiev drops it right down between the Americans. Good communication though. Gibb took it. Comes off Semenov's block and he's going over in two. Shame he'd gone over in two, but ball off the net doesn't count as a block, so you can't touch it again. I reckon if you put about 100 kg of muscle on Konstantin Semenov, you wouldn't look that dissimilar to Ivan Drago. I get the impression watching him, he's got about the same amount of fight in him. And again, the Americans send it long. They've just come off the boil here. And the Russians are very much back in this. 9-11. So, Gibb, a perfect cut shot across the net. They knew they were coming in for technical timeout. There was no point taking their own right before that. And in a way, Gibb did everything and more that a timeout could have done there. Showed Semenov that he's still got plenty more tricks up his sleeve when it comes to the net. So Gibb and Rosenthal, they only just snuck into these games ahead of the other American team of Furbringer and Lucina. And at the time, the beginning of 2012, they didn't look that strong. Fast forward 3 months, and they've now won the 2012 World Tour. And I think are one of the teams who are most assured of a medal here. Top three teams, undoubtedly, the two Brazilians and this American side. But outside hopes, certainly the Russians can't be written off quite yet. The Germans, Brink and Reckermann, who went through the quarterfinals earlier today, very, very strong. Right now, the Americans lead 12-9. Back out from the timeout, Gibb to serve. Goes into Prokopiev, Semenov sets. Great block. Gibb absolutely convinced that came off Semenov's arm. He will have the benefit of the replay, hopefully. Good check. Semenov. Sorry, Prokopiev giving the ball a little pep talk there. Again, he's just drawn Semenov into the net with a couple of blocks now. And having pulled him in close, he's just dinking the ball over him. He read the move from Prokopiev. He knew there was space to be exploited there. Rosenthal serves straight into Semenov. So we get Semenov at the net. Semenov versus Gibb. Semenov puts a lot on it, but Gibb sends it back. And at the moment for the Americans, it's all about placement. Haven't seen them unleash any kind of hand cannon yet. A copy of set Semenov. Oh, and it's in. That looked like it had come wide. It was right on the line. It must have been. Very, very passionate competitor. Gibb at the net. He doesn't make a mistake. 15-11. He just hammered that one as hard as he could. I imagine there was some placement in it, but certainly power took precedence. Gibb got the block, but it bounced straight out, so Russians take the point. A little bit of to and fro here, Russians trailing by 3 points. attention to Atul Gibb again. He is really upping that ratio. Almost 40%, I think, the ratio now. In fact, it is. It's 40% success rate for the Americans. Just over 25 for the Russians. So Prokopyev versus Gibb at the net. Rosenthal, plenty of time there. Oh, and a great block from Semenov. Still, this to and fro of the points doesn't see them close the gap to any less than 3 points. And fast closing in to the end of this set. Gibb. Oh, and he unleashes the power band from his right arm. 17-13. Too close to the net, and Gibb pounces on that one. Like a lamb running a little bit too close to the fence and getting picked off by a wolf. Gibb taking no prisoners up there at the net. He knows he's in a battle with Semenov. Prokopyev. Fantastic work by Rosenthal. Oh, and he comes off Semenov, so it's an American point. Referee just hesitated for a second there. Semenov doesn't even know. Semenov's walked back to take the point. Let's have a look at the replay. Semenov's a big fan of that. Semenov did it two or three times now. Couldn't get a good enough slow-mo to find out whether or not it was true. Oh my goodness! Rosenthal can't quite believe he got that back. An amazing block by Gibb against Semenov, and then Rosenthal finishes it off. The Americans are on set point. If anyone pumps Gibb up anymore, he might have a puncture. That meant an awful lot to the Americans. So, set point. Semenov sets Prokopyev. Gibb pulled away from the net, but he's Rosenthal sent that too close, and Semenov pounces. He barely needed to jump. With that arm, I reckon he stands almost 9 foot tall. Watch this, when it comes back from Rosenthal's dig. Rosenthal sets. Gibb finding the line. Prokopyev was down quickly, but not fast enough. So the Americans take the first set. Didn't have it all their own way to start with, but they just edged ahead. What started as a point lead became a 2 point lead, became a 3 point lead. Before long, the Russians found themselves trailing by 6. Semenov done some great work at the net, but he's been cancelled out point for point by some amazing work by Jacob Gibb. So set one statistics. 3 blocks to 2. Digs 17-13. No aces, but a much better attacking ratio from the Americans. I think that's down in large part to the diversity of Gibb and Rosenthal's arsenal of shots when they do get to the net. Whether it's cut shots, dinks, pokes, rolls, or smashes, the Americans seem to have them all locked down. bounced off the net. Prokopiev, who's got the reddest face I've seen throughout this contest. Played three other games and he hasn't looked like he's exerted himself this much. Prokopiev knows he's in a battle now. Gibb up to the net. Again, positions that beautifully. So, one all. Gibb to serve. Semenov down into the net. That luxury, the cushion of an entire set, they can relax, the pressure's off. The Russians know that every point counts now in large amounts. Oh, an amazing save, and then Rosenthal, that was a beautiful thing. Look at that, a big smile from Gibb there. He knows how well Rosenthal did, and you can't help feeling there is a really good, strong fan base here of Americans. The Russians relying on the underdog cheers from the neutrals. Comes off Gibb, goes long. They don't have the same level of support. Semenov to serve. Russians trail 2-3. And again, Gibb. Lethal at that net. I'm going to start calling him the Undertaker. That kill shots he's putting in there. So, according to my call dictionary, that's two cross-court blocks. Whatever it was, it didn't work. Prokopiev finding space between the two Americans. Laying claim to a much needed point. So Russians to serve, set trailing 3-4. Rosenthal, crisp little set there. And another great cut shot from Gibb. Got such an incredible angle. Didn't roll across the net, didn't get untidy. It just dropped perfectly down on the Russian side of the net. Prokopiev did anticipate it, but just too late. He covers a decent amount of ground there. Semenov had a go at lifting it, but only managed to get the net. Gibb serves and then quickly up for the net. And he does his best impression of a pylon. I know they don't have those in America. And the man is carrying some serious power. Must have picked it up from his time in Britain. Semenov sets. And the line judge said it's gone. Semenov again arguing the toss. Some treacherous ground there. I think Chinese referee could be running out of patience. Semenov asking for him to look at the replay. Good to serve. The Americans impassive at the back of the court during that protest. Prokopiev, finally he finds a little bit of variety to those shots. He drops one down to Gibb's right. Semenov to serve, Russians trail 4-7. Rosenthal to the net, puts it over the giant Russian. Lands on the line. The Russians are already losing touch with this set, I fear. Service error there. With little mistakes like that, we get the Russians' hopes up. Prokopyev sends the ball into Rosenthal. And it's straight off Semenov. Two consecutive points, 6-8 they trail. Gibb finds the ball off Semenov's block. And a bit of power, Prokopyev probably could have left that. Difficult call to make in the moment though, instinctively he hit that. And I'm pretty sure that's what Semenov's telling him now. Great work, you were positioned well. Didn't know if it was in or out. So, and then fallen off the Russians, the Americans. The Russians now find themselves back in this slightly. Big high set. And Prokopyev is able to attack it and get the deflection off Gibb at the net. 7-9. To take it all back, this is by no means over. To dive to catch that. Comes off the top of Semenov's block and out. So 10-7 to the Americans. Semenov sets again and Prokopyev has been mining a rich seam of points down the line there. Comes away with another one. Polish that one up. 16 carat beach volleyball point. Prokopyev. Another little pep talk for the ball there. Rosenthal jumping into that one. Ball rolls along the net, but back onto the American side. And the Russians are back within 1 point of the Americans. Adding those points up slowly though, and it is about patience and consistency. Semenov with a great block just when it's needed. Again he's up, pushes that one back, but Gibb is so fast. Oh, and they're saying it came off Semenov's block. Did roll his head to one side. Fantastic work at the net there by Semenov. So unlucky not to come away with a point. But I just talked about patience and consistency, and patience was exactly what the Americans had there. Waited their turn, didn't panic, just kept recycling the ball off the blocks. Semenov now sets for Prokopyev. Who comes off Gibb, and the Russians are back. 10-11, they trail, and we get to the technical timeout midway through this second set. The players concentrate on their timeout. I'm not kidding when I say about 400 people are congering around the top of the stadium. It's quite a phenomenal sight, actually. Rosenthal just glancing up at it there. You could see a kind of amused look on his face, I think. In fact, there's congers up and down every tier of the stadium at the moment. You can just see it in the top of the picture. You've got a widescreen television. Down here on the court, though, it is all business. BIDNISS. That's what these boys are talking about. Cold, hard points. 10 points separate Gibb and Rosenthal from a place in the quarterfinals. 11 points separate the Russians from a deciding third set. Semenov dancing around the court there, celebrating. Just flicking his fingers to let the referee know that he can't give it to anyone else.
Are you sure?
Line judge and referee having a little conversation about this. Is a Russian point. Semenov's protest vindicated. And the Russians have, for the first time in this set, if not both sets, got parity. Well, once you get out of the first 2 points, at least. Short-lived, though. Semenov, good block. But unfortunately, the ball fell on his side of the net. Rosenthal to serve. Prokopiev up to the net. And that was out. Rosenthal chasing after it like a salamander on his belly. So he knows better than anyone whether that was in or out. Semenov, having had one successful protest, could now be looking at all of them. A yellow card, hopefully. That will. Ooh. He may have a point here. Referee still dished out the yellow card, though. Doesn't like people approaching him too often. Rosenthal perfectly positioned, but could do nothing about it. So pick up here to serve. Control 12-13. Gibb to the net. Comes off Semenov. Semenov over in two, and he smashes that one down. If he was an astrologer, they'd call that Semenov's comet. A fantastic spike from the big Russian. So 13 all. And the Russians can see a light at the end of this second set. Rosenthal sets. Gibb versus Semenov. Prokopiev, fantastic work. Semenov has the guts to set for him as well, trusting that he'd be there, not being able to see him. And again, Prokopiev is there. Gibb and Rosenthal still patient, though. They're not letting any of these go. Semenov makes it. Can he get it back? Yes, he can. This is the best point of the day, if not the whole tournament. Rosenthal finally cracks, and the Russians win an incredible point to put them in the lead. It's not parity anymore. It's a lead. And Prokopiev and Semenov are over the moon with that one. That was a huge point to win. And I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see, if this next point goes to Russia, we're going to see that timeout. The Americans waited and waited and called a very late timeout. I was surprised that they didn't straight away. But they left that one. The Russians just think they were going to get to serve it for a second. And then at the last minute, pulled the timeout. That was a fantastic point. There, Semenov and Prokopiev working so hard to keep that ball alive. still very little profile on the World Tour, and yet these Russians have really pushed some of the best teams in this tournament. Look at the pools. They have the Swiss and the Germans ahead of them, two very good teams, and they have the Chinese team, who are tactically and physically very similar to the Russians. Prokopyev serves that one. Rosenthal at the net, and he sends that one long. The Americans are stumbling, ever so slightly, but they are stumbling. They have got that cushion of the first set, but the momentum has swapped sides here. Russia have found their mojo. Rosenthal powering that off Semenov's block. You can almost sense his frustration pent up in that shot. It's like a whip cracking. Indiana Jones, eat your heart out. Good serves. Bit of confusion there between the Russians, but they resolve it. Big block by Gibb, but the ball deflects straight out. The Russians take another point. 16-14. Oh, how the tables have turned. The lazy Susan has swung to the Russians, and they're 2 points ahead. 16-14. Semenov to serve. Lovely ding from Rosenthal, but only as far as Prokopyev. Comes off the net. And out are the Americans. Pull back to 15-16. This is going to be a fantastic close to a set. The stage is set here. Semenov sets. Prokopyev just outside the line. 16 all. Let's make it loud. So the Russians call a timeout. Each team has one timeout per set. We're getting to that point. Probably well used now. Prokopyev. Kind of, it's easy to forget about him in some senses because Semenov strikes such an imposing figure at the net. But Prokopyev has been the foundation of this Russian team. He's a workhorse, doing all of the pursuits at the back there. And he's positioned himself fantastically when reading Gibb or Rosenthal's attacks. The net is undoubtedly a Hollywood position. The defender can have his moments, I suppose, those spectacular digs. Prokopyev gets his own little moment there, though. And not that small 6'4" frame of Prokopyev gets a little pat on the head from Semenov there. 6'11", you can pat pretty much anyone on the head like a little boy, I suppose. Gibb sets. Rosenthal powers that one in, but it's long. And the Russians are 18-16 up at the end of this second set. The Russians very aware now that they can push this to three sets. Rosenthal again. He is hammering the ball into Semenov's block now. Venom in those. I can't quite get over how much his strategy's changed. potentially. He wants to draw Semenov in another couple of those big hits. And then he can revert back to the softer, better placed shots. Prokopiev again against Gibb, and Gibb gets the block in. Semenov sends it up, and again Gibb has the block. It's an emergency shot from Semenov, but it does the job. The Americans take their time, and there it is. Rosenthal with a beautifully placed shot. And the Americans pull back to 18-all. What a fantastic game. Having gone from two of the strongest teams at the games, the Americans could, it is a possibility now, lose both of their beach volleyball men's teams in one day. The Russians have taken another point, just 1 point away from set point. And that will really put the pressure on Dalhauser and Rogers. Sorry, Gibb and Rosenthal. They did lose two sets in the pool stage. Great block by Semenov, but it just slips down to his right onto the Russian side of the net. So back to 19-all. Prokopiev bounces off the net, gives Rosenthal a bit of time to make it, and now he attacks with his own cut shot. And after a phenomenal exchange of the last 10 points, at exactly the right moment, with impeccable timing, the Americans go to set point ahead of the Russians. It's not even set point, I apologise, this is match point for Sean Rosenthal. Serves. Semenov, I think, saying that Gibb was screening. Prokopiev at the net. Big block from Gibb, but it bounces out. 20-all. We're into tiebreak land now. We need two clear points. His brow knows what's coming. Oh, and Prokopiev with the first, oh no, his first service fault of this match. How heartbreaking is that? Couldn't have come at a worse time. He's crumbled under the pressure like Queen Elizabeth's teeth. Semenov, four touches for the Russians. It came off the net, not off the Americans. And Gibb, absolutely ecstatic, just flexes his muscles and stands rigid in front of the crowd screaming. If for a moment you thought the Americans were treating this as a gimme, or they thought it was going to be a pushover, think again. You saw exactly how much that meant in Jacob Gibb's face then. An incredible effort from the Russians. They so very nearly overturned that second set. I think the Russians can walk away with their heads held high. They did well reaching the last 16 here, and they gave a very good account of themselves when they got here. But the Americans are a class act. The best team, pound for pound, in the world right now. Jake Gibb and Sean Rosenthal. And they are in the quarterfinals. So 21-14, 22-20.